好 ，Linsing Global Jewelry Discovery 全球看珠宝第四期如约报道啦。前几期我们聊了意大利的贵族珠宝品牌，知名的鬼才珠宝设计师，印度裔的纽约宝石大批发商，至今尚且还没有给大家展示珠宝匠人、手艺人这一珠宝领域中不可或缺的重要一环。其实了解珠宝制造的人都知道，珠宝匠人工作时看起来并没有很光鲜，只能与各种器械工具为伍，甚至经常是满身金属碎屑，手指粗糙，皮肤黝黑。但恰恰是通过他们精湛的手艺辛苦付出，才有了一件件精美绝伦的珠宝珍品面世。所以今天这一期，我要带您走进美国纽约，去认识一位几乎用尽了自己的一生去拼搏奋斗在珠宝制造业的长者。他叫 Bakav Hagopin， 他的品牌叫做 The Hago。
那今天我来到这个位置呢，是美国纽约曼哈顿钻石区，然后我们一个好朋友的工作室，他的品牌呢叫做 The Hago， 是真正的一个珠宝匠人，凝聚了自己几十年的时间心血，倾注了很多的财力物力时间，然后来完成了这样一个Jewelry 的 factory， 诞生了真正很多优秀的而且是数不清的奇珍异宝，甚至来说他的作品被很多世界名人所收藏、所购买、佩戴。当然我在这边可能因为就是商业保密的原因，我不可能再提及到太多名人的名字，但是请你相信我，就是在美国甚至好莱坞很多明星、很多这个名人名媛，他们脖颈之间戴的一些项链，或者是说手上的一些戒指，都来自于我们 The Hago 先生的这样一个精美的一个制作。所以我也是特别特别的幸运，能够有机会来到他的 studio， 能够看到他的作品，能够聆听他设计灵感背后的故事，或者亲自来试戴一下他的珠宝。可以说我现在心情是非常非常激动的。
据我所知， Bakav Hagopin 并非出生在美国，而是亚美尼亚。作为一名后来移民，想要在寸土寸金、竞争无比激烈的美国珠宝业占得一席之地，已经是难上加难。更别提如何获得美国上流社会精英们的认可，动手设计制作百万美金级别的珠宝了。带着对他的好奇，我走进了 The Hago 的珠宝工厂。才一进门，Bakav 随手拿起了一件他正在制作的黄金钻石手链给我看，刹那间，这可真的让我目瞪口呆。
130 carats of diamond is there.
Oh my god， 这也太奢华了吧！感受到这种奢华的魅力了吗？我已经很词穷了。天哪！这是100多克拉的钻石，然后还有黄金，钻石就100多克拉，还没有镶嵌上主石，它中间有一些空档的地方，还要再镶嵌宝石上去。所以这是一件就是设计制作过程当中的一款手链，可以是手镯了吧？太奢华了 ！Oh my god！
It took us about to this piece.Like almost 4 months.
4 months.
Yes.
这条手链制作完成要4个月。
Yes.
4个月的时间。
类似这种4个月制作周期，且价格在百万美金级别的珠宝，对我们普通人来说肯定是难以企及的。但这对 The Hago 的团队来说并不少见。
Now, would you like to say hello to my audience?
Hello, hello, everybody. nice to meet you guys.
Can you share a little bit your background with us?
Yeah, I mean, I started working on the jewelry background, I would say about 13 years old.
13
yes.
years ago.
Yeah, I started and basically like a shop to shop. That made me, you know, more, you know, fluent on the jewelry. So pick up, you know, a lot of, you know, techniques, a lot of ideas from shop to shop. So that, I think, you know, that really made me a better craftsmanship overall. Yes, definitely. So, you know, I opened up my own shop around like 20, when I was 20 years old, so which is about like a 30, 32 years ago. So, and ever since then, you know, I try to design and you know, bring my piece to alive to you know, manufacture for big stones, small stones, whatever, you know, whatever I can do for jewelry.
在珠宝业，并不是任何一个人、任何一个团队就具备触碰珍贵稀缺宝石的能力。毕竟宝石价格太高昂，稍有技术不慎就会损失惨重。在我问到如何制作高级定制珠宝珍品最重要的一点时， Barkev 提到最多的就是他们精益求精的匠人精神。
Like we don't cut corners, you know, when you make a fine jewelry, there's only one way to make fine jewelry. You cannot cut corners. That's it. You gotta, you have to give, you know, some pieces takes, you know, months to finish.Some pieces take, you know, weeks to finish. So every piece is a unique, you know, you know, there is no cutting corners. So you want to find jewelry, you know, you have to give the, you know, not 100%, 1000% of your time to make it, you know, come out the best that it could be. You know?
说到设计灵感来源，Barkev 的回答却着实让我非常的意外。
So we just sketch something like this. Something rough sketch.
Rough sketch.
Yes. I get really nervous, like what I'm gonna design. You know,
really?
It's so true. Yes. Every piece that I touch, I don't know what to do. But once I start playing with stones, once I'm playing with the center stone, that's how I get my inspiration. Just touching the stones and putting the stones around, then all of a sudden, like something brand new piece comes out from nowhere. I mean, it's a.It's amazing, and able to create that, I think that's the ultimatum for me. I mean,
这也许就是人们常说的“由爱故生忧，由爱故生布”。正因为他一直带着对宝石的敬意、对技术的严格、对客人的负责、对珠宝行业真挚的爱，才会如此的谨小慎微、一丝不苟。相信很多朋友也会一直很好奇。珠宝设计到底是怎么样的一个完成过程呢？所以今天 Barkev 毫不吝啬地分享了 Dehago 关于设计部分的步骤流程，我们来听一听啦。
The first is a stone. I mean, like, you know,
we choose a stone.
Like, basically, what stones that they want exactly?、You know, like that's the stone that, you know,
such an emerald or any color.
Exactly, whatever they want, you know, whatever they want to finish. Number one is the stones. So.
Yeah, number one stone.
Yes.
Okay, so maybe step two.
Then number two, I would say designing, you know, how to, you know, do the design, sketching.
Like,
you know,
a designing. Yeah,
exactly,
part.
Designing.
Yeah.
Then from there, if everybody agreed what design they're going to do, so then mostly we're going to do...rendering, like what this is.
Yeah, step three.
After, after that is like a, you know, we goes to a caster.
Yeah.
We print it first.
Yeah, we print
it. Has to be printed in a
3D.
Yeah, 3D printer, right? So then it goes to silver modeling, which is, that's what it comes out from the, you know, from the casting. From that, we prep the model. For production, you know, sometimes it could be, you know, we take it directly from the printer just to, you know, fabricate it, or we can use a silver if you want to do, you know, like some adjustments or to see a mock-up. Then you know, we can take it from there. But from there, it'll be a gold production.
We should to choose which metal we want to use.
Yes, exactly, and then we'll choose exactly which metal needs to be, you know.Basically, we finish it in the factory,
like
with the setters, with the jewelers, with the polishers. So that's how we, you know, the final process.
And then later we can put on the center stone
yes.
on this ring.
Yes.
So then we finish the whole process.
如果说设计是一种梦想，而制作则是把梦想变为现实的唯一途径。有人会说，珠宝制作不过是一种加工流水作业吧？那么到底高级珠宝的定制有什么玄妙之处呢？让我们通过几件 Dehago 的高级定制珠宝来寻找答案吧。首先是我开篇提到的这一枚令人惊诧的100多克拉的黄金钻石手镯。
It's a very high-end piece. It's for one of our customer that he wanna, you know, have a big piece. We designed this for him. It took about 4 months because every piece that you see here is a separate.
Right now
it looks like a one piece, but the top is separate, the bottom is separate, you know, everything is separate. The inside, you can see the inside is like a mirror finish. Everything is so shiny.
Wow, that's right. So shiny even from the bike.
That's why
I can see the diamond.
That's why it takes, you know, long time to, you know, finish up that jewelry.The diamonds are all, you know, like nice quality diamonds. Everything is matched and everything is, you know, sized.
And color, and it's clarity.
Everything is like FGVS quality. Everything we use is good quality. And plus, every piece is handset under the microscope that,
you know,
yes. So we still have to put it together. You know, we're not done yet, but, you know, in a couple of weeks it should get done.
这种土豪级别的定制客户可都是非常神秘的，而且不惜重金，要的就是足够奢华，无与伦比。当然，小而精致又别有设计趣味的珠宝在 Dehago 这里也见得到哦，用心程度丝毫不会被打折扣。
When I designed this, it's like a, you know, I wanted to design some kind of like a more like a flowery type.
我觉得这一套可以叫做盛开的鲜花。 Mr. Dehago 先生呢就是用到了花朵的这样一个设计灵感，但是你会发现以前我们见到一些花朵的时候好像已经司空见惯了，就是没有什么亮点哈。但是这一款的时候我们看到它从每个角度看上去不是在一个平面上的，它真正实现了一个三维立体的一个效果，甚至你连每一个花瓣当中翘起的弧度大家可以看一下都是与众不同的，每一个完全不会重复。哇，天哪，虽然它不是说用到非常巨大的宝石去衬托，但是你依然可以看到了每一颗小的钻石之间它做到了无缝拼镶，然后你用手摸上去的时候呢是非常的光滑平滑的，这是特别考验到珠宝匠人制作的一个工艺标准。看盛开的，这是黄色的，这个一朵用到了黄金和钻石，白金和钻石，这一颗呢也是白金和钻石，但是它用到了两个桥梁的一个搭配，把我们中间这颗钻石花衬托得特别的璀璨和闪耀。当然这一款呢更不用说了，也是用到了非常复杂的一个工艺，做到了我们是10个 piece 单独去制作，然后把它结合在一起，才能形成一朵非常漂亮的黄色的这样一朵花朵。当然这个黄色是用到了黄钻来完成的，真的太漂亮了，完全不想摘下来呀，好想都带回家。
这枚大大的黄钻花朵戒指用的颜色是 fancy yellow color， 全部10片花瓣都是独立的，需要逐一手工制作花瓣的曲线和倾斜角度，使它完全实现如真花一般的姿态。 Dehago 对于珠宝制作的认真程度已经达到了痴迷和疯狂。钻石戒指一定是大家最关注的吧，而大克拉钻戒更是成为女人幸福指数的象征了。 Dehago 这几十年来不断的推陈出新，讲究每一款钻戒出新后绝不撞款，即便有人抄袭它的设计，但是也绝仿造不出它的精湛手艺。
For this one, like a 5 carat diamond.
Five carat, exactly.
And the round shape. Yeah. When you're spending your money for 5 carat, which is probably gonna cost you like close to $200,000 or maybe more, so you make sure that the piece that you are holding, it's like 100% the satisfactory.
Yeah,
you know, there is no cutting corners.
今天在 Mr. Dehago 的办公室我又学到了很多，他说无论是买珠宝的时候，你不仅要看正面，还要看它的侧面、背面，还有它里面的部分，就是一个真正的技术非常 精湛的珠宝制作者，他不只是说图表面的功夫，他会从每一个细节不留下任何的死角和暗角，让大家真正你钱花在这个珠宝上面的时候，它是能够伴随你一生的。所以这就是一个珠宝匠人他自己的一份心愿在里头，时刻呢是以最高标准来严格的要求自己。
我知道大家和我一样对钻戒最情有独钟，让我们再来看几款其他的设计吧。其中异形钻石在国际上可是非常受欢迎的哦。
This is like a you can put like a 5-carat or 6-carat diamond in there. Yes, it's an emerald cut.
Emerald cut.
Yeah, you can see the detail work. You see inside is like the same like the outside.
Of course.
Right?
Yeah.
Because why? Mm-hmm. Because this piece is separate. Everything is separate. So we clean everything, then assemble it together. That's why this piece is.All the details are like, you know, you can see how perfect the details are.
Yeah.
And it is done under the microscope. It's not an easy job. It's a very time consuming job, but at the end, look what comes out. I mean, it comes out beautiful. I mean, this is like one of my favorite piece.
往往最奢华的珠宝就代表着它具备超级多的细节，而每一层细节都要分开设计，在显微镜下慢慢的镶嵌完成，达到正反面都是镜面效果般完美，而这既耗费功力又耗费时间。而巴坎本人最爱的这一款钻戒，很好地为我们展示了高级珠宝的魅力和制造者的实力。现代时尚女性很追逐通勤珠宝，精致低调而又独特的珠宝在大都市越来越受追捧喽。那么在纽约，职场女士最喜欢戴什么呢？让我们来看一看这一款吧。
It looks like three rings, but it's actually one ring. Everything is put together. Actually, that's one of my new designs. Actually, it's like a stop sign.
Oh,
yes.
Stop sign.
Yes.
大家记得那个 stop sign 就是停车牌吗？也只是牌是这个形状。Oh, so you get that inspiration
yes,
from
exactly.
stop sign. Oh, 三个单独的戒指，然后你可以把它叠搭在一起来进行佩戴，然后形成了一种与众不同的风格。但你也可以就是把它，比如说单独一个、两个，日常生活当中去佩戴也可以。哦，我觉得这一款还可以就是搭配我们订婚的那个钻石戒指来戴。但是三款叠在一起的时候，哇，好漂亮，就是特别的和谐，而且很独特，特别有这种我们说女性应该有一种知性之美、典雅之美。
白色钻石和各种彩色宝石的多层夹心设计，摆脱了单调，多了棱角和色彩，而又无止境、无限制的可以佩戴，这便是通勤珠宝的强大吸引力喽。在我已经看花了眼的时候，巴凯夫拿出一条刚刚制作完毕的铂金钻石手链，非要我试戴一下。
Not just from the top, even from the side.Even from the back.
Oh my god!
See how everything is clean.
这种高级定制的手链垂坠，奢华之美让我终身难忘。
这是一款钻石手链，中间全部用到了法棍形状的天然钻石，而且呢，在从小到大，它中间最大，两边向小，两侧逐渐缩小，然后这边做到了一个椭圆形双环的设计，这里面全部镶嵌的白色的这样一个天然真钻。所以环环相扣在其中，象征着一种就是连绵不绝的循环的一种幸福之感。哇，天哪，真的太漂亮了！我这样用手摸上去的时候，各个角落都是特别的平滑，而且呢，镶嵌起来的这个工艺难度非常的高，能够做到这种精湛的技术，真的是让我今天没有白来一趟。太漂亮了。So may I ask about this price?
This one I sell it for about 60,000 US.
60,000
US.
我的纽约探宝之旅的确不虚此行，收获良多。世界之大，珍宝之多，能人之广，极大丰富了我的眼界。也许有人说珠宝不能吃不能喝，甚至还有人说钻石就是最大的世纪骗局，但我想说，高级定制珠宝的魅力岂是三言两语可下论断的？这门博大精深、世代相传的珠宝学问，是值得细细品味、永久相伴的。
好了，纽约之旅到此结束。下期 Lindsay Global Jewelry Discovery， 我带您去美国丹佛寻找一位神奇的宝石学家。更多精彩，未完待续哦。